There was a grievous famine in the land of Canaan, and the people could not stay, so Abram and his people arose and went to Egypt, and when they were at the brook Mitzrayim, they rested from the fatigue of the road. Abram and Sarai were walking, and he beheld his wife, that she was very beautiful. And he said to her, "Since Ahayah has created thee with such a beautiful countenance, I am afraid of the Egyptians. They may slay me and take you away. For the fear of Ahayah, our God, is not in these places. Say that you're my sister to all that ask, so I may live." Abram commanded the same to all those that came with him to Egypt. Yet Abram did not trust them. But he took Sarai and placed her in a chest and concealed it amongst their vessels. For Abram was greatly concerned about Sarai because of the wickedness of the Egyptians. Abram with the people that were with him came to Egypt and brought the chest in which Sarai was concealed, and the Egyptians saw the chest. The king's servants approached Abram, saying, "What hast thou here in this chest which we have not seen? Now open thou the chest, and give tithe to the king of all that it contains." Abram said, "This chest I will not open, but all you demand upon it I will give." And Pharaoh's officers said, "It is a chest of precious stones. Give us the one-tenth." The king's officers pressed Abram, and they reached the chest and opened it with force. And they saw, and behold, a beautiful woman was in the chest. When the officers saw Sarai, they were struck with admiration at her beauty, and all the princes and servants of Pharaoh assembled to see Sarai, for she was very beautiful. They told Pharaoh about Sarai's beauty, and they praised Sarai to the king. And Pharaoh ordered her to be brought, and she came before the king. Pharaoh saw Sarai, and she pleased him exceedingly, and he was struck with her beauty. And the king rejoiced greatly and made presents to those who brought him the tidings concerning her. She was then brought to Pharaoh's house, and Abram grieved on account of his wife, and he prayed to the Lord to deliver her from the hands of Pharaoh.
Sarai also prayed at that time and said, "O Lord Ahayah, thou didst tell my lord Abram to go from his land and from his father's house to the land of Canaan. And thou didst promise to do well with him if he would perform thy commands. Now behold, we have done that which thou didst command us, and we left our land and our families, and we went to a strange land and to a people whom we have not known before. We came to this land to avoid the famine, and this evil accident has befallen me. Now therefore, O Lord Ahayah, deliver us and save us from the hand of this oppressor, and do well with me for the sake of thy mercy."
The Most High Ahayah hearkened to the voice of Sarai, and the Lord sent an angel to deliver Sarai from the power of Pharaoh. The king came and sat before Sarai, and behold, an angel of the Lord was standing over them. And he appeared to Sarai and said to her, "Do not fear, for the Lord has heard thy prayer." The king asked her, "Who is the man who came with you?" And she said, "He is my brother." The king said, "It is incumbent upon us to make him great, to elevate him, and to do unto him all the good which thou shalt command us." And at that time the king sent to Abram silver and gold and precious stones in abundance, together with cattle, men servants, and maid servants. And the king ordered Abram to be brought, and he sat in the court of the king's house. And the king greatly exalted Abram on that night. The king approached to speak to Sarai, and he reached out his hand to touch her, when the angel smote him heavily, and he was terrified, and he refrained from reaching her. The angel smote him to the ground and did this to him the whole night, and the king was terrified. The angel on that night smote heavily all the servants of the king and his whole household because of Sarai, and there was a great lamentation that night amongst the people of Pharaoh's house. Sarai exemplified unwavering faith in Ahayah, demonstrating profound spiritual and physical beauty. She embodied grace and elegance, serving as a steadfast companion and invaluable support to Abram. Throughout challenges, Sarai remained serene, never contentious or disobedient, always turning to prayer in adversity. Her humility and unwavering loyalty shone brightly, as did her boundless love and unparalleled purity, making her a beacon of virtue in her era. Sarai's life stands as a compelling testament to women of all ages, inspiring them with her devotion, wisdom, and unparalleled goodness.